Welcome to another video. Today we don't want to talk about UI customization when it comes to the aesthetics of it, but the effect and how you can actively use them to make your gameplay more effective and how you can optimize your key bindings. First of all, again, I'm trying to do this without a script. I'm trying to just speak about my personal experiences. So yeah, my apologies for my English, like always. I'm trying to improve that, and hopefully in Endwalker we can have very fluid and solid videos like that without the need of a script behind it. Okay, first of all, you have to make sure that you have the proper hardware to accomplish your setup. Of course, for those people with a controller, I haven't played a controller setup yet, so I can't tell you much about this. You should check out Work2Game, they have very, very good optimized controller guides, gamepad guides, so definitely leave a visit to their channel and check out their controller guides. But of course, on the other hand, there's the setup that I have myself, which features a keyboard and an MMO mouse, which is kinda the addition to the usual mouse, with having more thumb buttons that you can have, like 12 thumb buttons where you can bind certain skills on, or you can bind certain abilities on, or potions, or any useful fighting macros, whatever, your mount, sprint, all the buttons that you need for your character. So there's one thing, my setup kinda looks good, but it's actually very chaotic from the inside. So how I bound it actually doesn't make much sense, but it does for me. And that's the main thing you need to take care of, that your setup, your key bindings make sense for you. First of all, the basic thing to change that is, like always, you go into your system settings and from there on you navigate towards key binding or key bind. And from here you can adjust everything that is redirected onto your hotbar. For example, you can see I'm just using hotbar 1, 2 and 3 for all my skills. So there's nothing more than these three hotbars. Everything else I do with this collapsing hotbar system that you may be familiar with already from my other videos. I also updated that video about this topic, so check this out if you're very curious about this topic or haven't watched the video yet. It really helps remove the clutter of your UI and make everything more clear and clean, and have all these not very active commands that you don't use in combat bound to this list here. Changing jobs, changing professions, using your mount selection or whatever. But of course, when it comes to my usual keys, these are the most usual keys I use for my character, especially like sprint, for example, like flying, mount, roulette. These are super necessary and super essential. And when it comes to these key bindings, the main thing is that you are comfortable with your setup. Of course, you will start at WASD, which is the basic movement pattern that you're using since, or we are using all together since the early times of shooters that introduced this kind of movement setup. And everything that lays around this WASD hotkeys or keys on your keyboard is kind of a good way to use skills or to lay skills on, because you can perfectly reach them with your fingers without stretching them too far. Like, for example, I think something like T, G and B would be a bit too far again, but on the other hand, R, E, Q, C, V, Y, these are kind of good options to use here. I personally don't use Y because that would be a stretch downwards and I would have to use my middle finger down and can't navigate in front of me, so that would stop my movement, which is not very good, and I don't like to bind it there. While the other buttons like Q, E, I can perfectly reach here and don't have any problem in navigating my skills towards that spot. Okay, if you're having an MMO mouse, which I honestly can recommend, because it just provides more buttons without any more additional costs, because you can buy these mice for around 30 to 40 bucks already. I think they're very cheap options that still work perfectly fine and you can still use them. Of course, you don't need to have the Razer Naga Pro, which I use, which is a wireless version. There's also the Razer Naga X, for example, which is the same mouse, more lightweight, and has the same functionalities with the thumb buttons. But there are also non-branded mouses that I have tested myself that are perfectly fine, like something from Red Dragon. They produce very nice mouses and mice. I don't know how, about the plural, sorry. Yeah, they produce very good hardware, and you can definitely choose one of those for very cheap and for a good price ratio. And yeah, of course, that allows you and toggles some more buttons. You can see these named as num in my setup here, because num actually means that you sometimes have to bind these to the numpad. The numpad doesn't need to be there physically, because I'm actually not having a numpad right now, but you just need to take any keyboard that is laying around in your house, in your apartment, wherever you can find one with a numpad, and one time you just use that. You can also just use the Windows integrated virtual keyboard to bind these hotkeys or these thumb buttons of your MMO mouse to these numpad buttons. So that's vertically not a problem, as long as you're just binding them. Afterwards, you can just unplug the keyboard that you used it for and use any TKL or smaller size keyboards as well without any struggle there. Of course, this works for laptops as well. There's also mouse buttons that I'm having on my mouse that are also bound into the setup, but the main thing that you also don't have to use these, because yeah, it's not necessary, because we're having shift, alt and control modifiers, for example. These are super, super helpful, and I'm also using them, for example, if I use my 2, it's intervene, for example, but if I use my shift 2, it's my mount, and I always bind it at the same spot. The mount is always the same. You can see that on all my characters, it's always on shift 2, and sprint is always on shift 3, so these are kind of the split key binds that I use on all characters in the same way. On the other hand, from the logical standpoint, I always try to bind the same kind of spells to the same buttons, but to be completely honest with you, and as a follow-up to my first keybinding video that I already did on this channel, it actually doesn't matter. You will get used to every setup that you make, as long as you're not changing it constantly. For example, some things do really differ, like my healer setup is really completely a different thing than my tanking setup, for example. You see, the damaging spells are actually on my mouse buttons, my thumb button 1 and thumb button 2, while my healing spells are 1, 2, 3, 4. That is actually the opposite of using my tank's skills, where I have the more consumer-heavy attacks, like Quietus, that is consuming my gauge costs here, my gauge energy, and Carve and Spit, that has a 60 second recast timer. So actually abilities that I don't use very often, and this is definitely a different setup here. And then I have my base rotation being split to 1 Q, and the follow up is Shift Q, for example, the Soul Eater. Yeah, it's really, really weird sometimes, because it actually does not make sense, but I can perfectly play this. It's completely in my brain, I can't get rid of it. So even if I would drop Final Fantasy IV half a year, I would still remember all these setups perfectly fine. So as long as you're just doing whatever you do, you get some practice on this, and don't worry about the thumb buttons on an MMO mouse, you will get used to this in quite a while. It takes some time. I think back in Wrath of Lich King, I bought my first MMO mouse ever, and I was struggling like 3 or 4 weeks with that, and after that it was perfectly fine. So don't worry about that. Everything is muscle memory, everything gets used here, and you should just make sure that you're having a perfect setup for yourself that you can reach. So the most important principle here is that you have buttons that you don't struggle with reaching. For example, Shirk, in this case, for my tank, is on 5, and 5 is really, really far away from my WASD combo. So this is kinda not optimal version here. The same applies for R, which I have my Delirium on, and Shift R, which is something like the Blackest Night. But for me personally, it's still way better than 5. It makes a whole lot of difference to click this than using my Shirk, because my hand doesn't move that much. Maybe this is the most important factor for you to see if that actually makes sense for your hotkey setup, if your hand has to stretch out very heavily and you have to move your hand along very, very intensively. So keep that in mind, that this is kind of the indicator of a good setup or not. If your hand can just easily lay on WASD and reach every other button without stretching it too far, without kind of feeling some bad movement happening, it's perfectly fine. You will memorize everything. So there's, forget about all the perfect setup things. You can just throw a trash setup like I have, and as long as you remember that, it's perfectly fine. Don't worry about memorizing stuff. It will come naturally and you will remember that. And as long as you're playing this for quite some time, you will always come back and can remember that. For example, I can just go in here and you can see my mount is perfectly fine using... I actually fall off the tower. That's quite funny. Okay, so for example, I can just switch to my machinist here, and this perfectly shows that we have more skills on the paladin, for example. And you don't actually need more than 3 hotbars total. You can use 3 hotbars for all your spells, and I guess that even in Endwalker, they won't introduce more spells than you can get on these 3 hotbars. So just don't worry about that. And for example, like on jobs like on the machinist, you can see that there's actually less hotkeys needed. Because, yeah, that's all the spells that are there. And you can see the free spaces here. It's trash. It looks like trash, but it's perfectly fine because I bounded all my usual things and my required abilities to the buttons that I need. And here I just use my buffing and can directly drill the target, use my air anchor, use my OGCDs perfectly fine, and it's all in a good reach. It's nothing that has to be done very often. So in my case, in my scenario here, the only thing that is kinda off-putting is the 5, and I just bind all the not so necessary spells to my 5, for example, like Paladin. Yeah, you use this in between fights when you're walking in dungeons, when you're walking from boss to boss in 24-man raids or something. Yeah, it's super useful there. But on the other hand, you don't use that in a very, very important situation, like in fights or anything like that. So yeah, just make sure that you can reach every button with your hand properly and that you're having kinda a good idea about your setup that will automatically memorize itself. So don't worry about that too much. Just go into your keybinding setups here and use whatever hotbars you have at your disposal. Maybe a 4th hotbar is also fine because you can bind certain battle calls or macros to that you may use here for like having macros for certain boss fights, like the strategies that you can post there or anything like that. And of course have your gauge kind of next to that for the management itself and for having track of your management. But everything, as long as it's in reach of your fingers and you have your shifts and alt modifiers, I personally really just use shift. There's no alt or control modifier because I feel like using alt or control is alternating my hand positioning, and that's bad. I just want to have the natural WASD movement positioning here, and that I can easily just use whatever I need to switch between my skills and movement, and that is shift. I think shift is the sweet spot. Shift is my personal recommendation. And if you haven't started using modifier keys on your keyboard, I would just recommend to start with shift whatsoever. Okay guys, that's it. I'm sorry about having no script and that this may be a very spontaneous video. Yeah, as some of you may know, I'm working on very, very intense projects like the Relic Armor Showcase that should be released in 2 days or tomorrow, hopefully. And yeah, have fun with the live stream today. The 14-hour live stream starting on, I think, 6 p.m. 6 p.m. Yeah, I think 6 p.m. GMT or something like that. And yeah, have a wonderful weekend, have a wonderful stay in Eorzea, in Novrand, in Final Fantasy, and yeah, have a lot of fun with your some ideas and tips about the keybinds that may improve your life and your battle plan, your battle rotation significantly, as it is for me, especially with using an MMO mouse. Okay, thanks for watching, sorry for the long video, but nonetheless, have a wonderful weekend, stay safe, stay healthy, and keep loving Final Fantasy.